In our research, archaeological experimentation involves the human body directly, thus marking the body of the clay during the production process. Here we assume the composite body that's linked to its community of practice, materials, and context. In this study, as a methodological and epistemic proposal, we have created a team which includes apprentices, practices, and teachers as to understand and reproduce ceramic artifacts attributed to the Tupi-Guarani tradition. We chose the archaeological site Floresta 2, which is located in the municipality of Itueta, in the state of Minas Gerais, Brazil, as a guide for replicating the ceramic pieces, since it is a well-studied site by our Museu de História Natural Jardim Botânico UFMG team. The purpose of replicating these pieces was both to conjecture on the learning of ceramics and their marks, as well as to create artifacts in order to compose the museum's permanent exhibition. Since we observed the differences in motor maturation, experience, and practice in our production, we could also identify the same marks and gestures in the archaeological pieces we have studied. In our experiments, demonstrations, and in workshops that we give to different age groups, we have been able to notice the unevenness in the results of execution for each task that was requested. These gestural differences indicated not only our mannerisms, but also our experience and practice in pottery, since they spoke of our own body as a cyborg body as it learns how to use the instruments we have created. Skill, in this sense, come as a result of practice as well as an educational process within traditional communities. Fire is essential for the transformation of clay into ceramics, and it has been targeted in this research, since we have aimed at replicating traditional techniques of fire by friction. It's not an easy task to make fire in such a way. We have noticed that the slightest misalignment of knees, legs, and abdomen influences and determines the result. Body training is needed to activate sensory and the kinesthetic aspects demanded by the technique. Making the path of fire and making it embrace the pieces appropriately requires multiple types of knowledge in order to achieve success. During our experiments, some artifacts were transformed into broken pieces and not containers, and we have learned at each stage. It takes persistence, as the master potters teach us. As a consequence of this research, we can say that the experiments have taught us about motor variability and the marks it creates on pottery, as well as its teaching and learning process. We have learned about the long journey of skill building as a result of practice and commitment, since it involves multiple layers of knowledge at each productive stage. Such approach allows new colors into the past scenario with several historical agents at many different ages and abilities. Thus, we could observe in the archaeological pieces the presence of apprentices, practices, and masters in the art of pottery, involving children, young people, adults, and seniors as well. In some cases, we could identify pieces that were made collaboratively. As a result of displaying such knowledge, in November of 2019, the replicas of the pieces were used to compose the permanent exhibition of the Museu de História Natural Jardim Botânico of UFMG, entitled Diversity in the Indigenous Archaeological Context of Minas Gerais over the last 14,000 years. Due to the public health restrictions imposed since March 2020 as a result of the COVID pandemic, face-to-face visits, which involved around 40,000 people per year, were suspended. Since then, two different teams connected to the museum have started to develop scientific content for social networks. This initiative was a great strategy to expand our dialogue network and create mechanisms of knowledge communication during this pandemic period.